what other questions do you have for me at this point, just going forward for the next couple of months?
Yeah. So, so this is like, I guess like a studying technique or a studying question. I've oscillated from studying like crazy. Like I work part-time, so I've oscillated from studying literally every hour that I wasn't sleeping or working to getting burnt out and then taking like 2 weeks off and then trying to see if I could be more realistic. But then I don't always know what to study. So like, I'll know I'm supposed to study tomorrow for like 3 hours, but then I'll sit down and be like, well, I spend the first hour like, well, what am I supposed to be studying? Do you have any recommendations on like how to build, now that I have 2 months and I know where I need to go, I know that I need to gain those extra couple points, what should I do? Should I like build a study plan, like an Excel spreadsheet? I don't know. Do you have any recommendations or advice?
Definitely, Dylan. This has definitely been an area of focus of mine, actually. So, because you need a plan of attack. It's too hard to go it alone, just using the books and just using the prep tests, because people just fall into this trap where they just do all the prep tests in order.
Yeah, and I've burned through. I've definitely made the same mistake you did. I've burned through a lot of them. Especially the later ones, I haven't. But I've burned through them way too fast. But yeah.
Yeah. So I think in this case, what you want to do is you want to slow down to speed up. Meaning you focus on a handful of exams in more detail. And if you still have some work to do on your foundation, you can focus your studying in three phases: accuracy first, doing questions by type untimed, then pacing with individual timed sections, and then bring it all together in the last phase with full length 5-section timed exams. But you want to do some questions by type just to build your foundation, especially any weak areas you discover along the way, if they are particular question types. On the other hand, if you're not finding any particular trends, or you just find that you get a lot of necessary assumption questions wrong or a lot of flaw questions wrong, that could simply be because there are a lot of those questions out there on the exam, right?
Right.
Selection bias. So figure out if you're getting a certain question type disproportionately wrong more often, or if there's a certain type that you just always hate to see. That's, of course, the area that you need to focus on. I've got some study schedules on my website. I have free week-by-week ones. I also have more detailed premium day-by-day plans where I really break it down bit by bit, not just doing ordering, then grouping, then combination games, but doing the easiest ordering games first and working up to the more difficult ordering games. And I'll also tell you, read these pages in these prep books, read these articles on my site, and then do the practice problems. But I really try to systematize it, because the worst thing you can do is just burn through a lot of recent material that isn't available anymore to measure yourself later.
Right. All right.
So I gather that you haven't used the schedules yet. Are there any resources of mine that you have used?
Yeah. So, because I've used so many different ones that I've kind of like lost track with what I've done. but a lot of your like the sheets that you've created, a lot of like the general guides I've printed out, and I have them in my study materials. But I think I've spent a lot more time with Seven Sage. I think that might not be working for me as much. So I need to dig deeper into your resources, and see what that could offer as well. But yeah, I like that advice.